So what is a phonetic approach to beatboxing? Well, phonetics is the study of how we make sounds with the human mouth. Now, phonetics is usually preserved to how sounds are made to make language in different languages across the world. But we're applying the same techniques to beatboxing. So what we're doing is we're going to look how we actually make the sounds, how we physically create the sounds. And as you'll see, by learning how we physically create the sounds from scratch and learning a bit about how sounds are created in the mouth, it'll lead on to us making and combining sounds together to make new sounds. So a phonetical approach to beatboxing is very important. Now there are four types of sound we make in human beatboxing. The first kind of sound that we make in human beatboxing are called plosives. Now, plosives are sounds where we stop the airway and release sound. Now, because of that, they're sometimes called stops. And plosives are things like ba, can you say ba? And ka, ka, and ta, and ga. They're all plosives. And that's the first kind of sound. Think of them as being explosive. They're the sounds where you stop the sound and you release it suddenly. Pa, ka, ta, ba, ga. They're all plosives. Now, the second kind of sound that beatboxers make are called fricatives. And fricatives are those continuous sounds. Things like sh and f and h. They're all fricatives. They're the continuous sounds. The third kind of sound that beatboxers make are called the clicks. And there are all kinds of clicks that beatboxers make. Things like and lots of different kind of click sounds. And the fourth kind of sound that beatboxers make are oscillations. Now, an oscillation means something that goes up and down continuously or vibrate continuously. And oscillations include things like this, and they're all oscillations. So beatboxers make four kinds of sound: plosives, pa 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 ka 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 ta ta ta, fricatives, sh, f, s, clicks, and oscillations. Got it? Four kinds of sound. Now, plosives are the first group of sounds that beatboxers make, and they make them by stopping the airway and releasing sound out. And there are different kinds of plosive that you can make with the human mouth by stopping the sound with different parts of the anatomy of your mouth. So the first obvious kind of plosive is to just say ba, like that, ba, like if you're going to say bogies, yeah, ba for bogies. And that's called a bilabial plosive. Bilabial means lips, two, bi means two, and labial means lips, so two lips plosive. Bilabial is just the posh kind of phonetical term that scientists like to use. They can't just say lip plosive, but yeah, because it uses both your lips, pa. Ba, ba, ba. And pa is another one, yeah. Pa is another bilabial plosive. Ba for bogies and pa for print. They're both bilabial plosives. Now, there are other plosives that we make. What about one using our throat like this? Ka, 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 ka. Or g, 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 using the glottis down there. Gl, g, g, g. Ka, 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 g, g, g. They're using different parts of our anatomy in the mouth. And also, what about this sound? T, t, t. Another plosive using the tongue and the alveolar ridge. That's that bony bit above your front teeth. T, 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 t. So there are all different kinds of plosives that we make, and the plosives sound different because they're using different parts of your anatomy in the mouth. The very first kind of plosive you're going to learn that beatboxers make is the hi-hat. Now remember, the hi-hat is a cymbal sound. It's a sound that is used to kind of continually keep a rhythm in the beat. And it's a very simple sound to make. The hi-hat is just a t sound, like this. Now what we do is we just do a breathe out very slightly, or just eject the sound out of our mouth by pressing our tongue against our front teeth, or just the alveolar ridge above our front teeth, like that, to make a T sound. Now you'll notice in the notation that the T is lowercase. It's a lowercase T, it's not a capital T that we use to describe the sound, and that's very important, as we'll see it a bit later on. So to make the hi-hat sound, it's just a t, 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 t. Try and not breathe out, just go t, t, t. Eject the air from your mouth, t, 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 like that. Now this next bit is really important, because plosives come in two kinds, two varieties. Not just using the different parts of our anatomy of the mouth, but they can be either forced or unforced. This is really important to learn, because if I just say bogies, say bogies. I can't believe you just said bogies. But anyway, sorry, I'm being sensible now. If you just say bogies, the b sound isn't very loud, is it? Can you hear that? B, b, bogies, b, 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 b. Not very loud. But if we want to make a kick drum sound, as we'll see later, we're going to force the air out between our lips. The same as a B, but we're going to do it a lot louder, like this. And then we're forcing the air out. That's called a forced plosive. Now, forced plosives we can do with any of the sounds, any of the plosive sounds that we make with our mouth. In fact, if I do a and force it, it becomes. If I do a, which is a K sound, and force it, it becomes. So we can force the air through the tight gap with much more power, and it vibrates slightly, and that's a forced plosive. Now in language, we don't use forced plosives very much at all. In fact, nearly all the plosives that we make, where we're going b or p or k or t, are very quiet. They're not forced plosives. So if I say tennis, it's not tennis. And if I say cabbage, it's not cabbage, it's just k, very gently. So that's an unforced plosive. But in beatboxing, we're going to make a lot of the sounds forced. Now, the hi-hat sound that we learnt earlier is an unforced plosive, the t, 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 t. But as we'll see later on, a lot of our snares and kicks and other sounds that we make will be forced. They'll be forced plosives, squeezing that air out very tightly. And I'm going to teach you to make some forced plosives in a moment. Now the very first kick drum sound that you want to learn as a human beatboxer is the classic kick. It's called the classic kick because it was one of the first kick drums that beatboxers used. Classic sound from the early 1980s. And it's a forced B. Now if I do a B sound, and I want to notate it, you'll see that it's a lowercase b because it's not forced. When we write a forced sound, we're going to use a capital letter. So for a forced b, it becomes b. We're going to use a capital B. So what I want you to do is start with your lips together. I want you to, rather than just kind of just go b, I want you to try and vibrate your lips almost as if you're going to go like that, if you're going to spit something out of your mouth. But do it very short and very quickly. Just force air through that really tight gap and you end up with, and that becomes our kick drum. Can you hear the difference? It's not. It's. And that's a forced B sound, or the classic kick drum. Now, fricatives are continuous sounds that we make with the mouth. And there are all sorts of fricatives that we can make. The easiest one, perhaps, is just to say shh, like that. Shh, where we use our tongue and the roof of our mouth to restrict the airflow, and we breathe out to make a shh sound. Now, there are other fricatives too. F is another one, like this. Yeah, using your teeth on your lower lip and just restricting, not closing completely like a plosive, but restricting the airflow to create that kind of whooshing noise. Another one is creating a very small airway between the tip of your tongue and the roof of your mouth. Like that. You can even just make a fricative making a sound. Can you hear that? By restricting the airflow out of your throat. Rather than just breathing out and making no sound, yeah, by restricting it, it becomes louder. Yeah? Or we can use the back of our tongue and the roof of our mouth, like this. So the back of our tongue, which is normally laying down flat, if we squeeze it up near the roof of our mouth, at the back of our tongue, we end up that kind of ch sound. And by shaping the mouth, we can create another fricative sound. Now, fricatives are going to be really useful, as we'll see later on, by combining them with plosives. There's a special term for that when you combine a fricative and a plosive at the same time. It's called an affricate, but we don't need to know that, so I might just go back and, should we rewind and delete that bit? I don't know, affricates, who needs to know that? But we're going to combine fricatives and plosives to make our first snare drum sound. Now, the classic snare drum sound, one of the first snare drums that beatboxers used, combined a plosive and a fricative. Now, we can combine any plosive and any fricative and make very complex sounds, as we'll see later on. But the very first one we're going to do is to make a forced puh sound like this. So instead of going puh, it becomes like that. Imagine you're spitting out some tea leaves or something like that. So that's forcing the airway very tightly through very tight lips like that. And we're going to use the fricative shh. Now notice that as we notate those, that the forced P sound, the is a capital P, and because the fricative is unforced, it's just a sh sound, we're going to be using lowercase letters for that. And we combine the two, so we end up with and sh together, like this. Now, I'm making that quite long to show you that it's two sounds together. And why do we have those two sounds? If you remember from our introduction, every snare drum has the sound of the stick hitting the top of the drum, the skin of the drum, and it has the rattle underneath of the snares. So the is the stick hitting, and the rattle underneath is the sh. So we always need two sounds for a snare drum, a plosive and a fricative. And sh becomes so, you've learnt three sounds. You've learnt the classic kick drum, which is lips slightly floppy, but pushing the air out, forcing the air out for a sound. Then tightening the lips up and forcing the air out for a sound. Hear the difference? Loose lips, force the air out. Tight lips, force the air out. You've learnt your hi-hat. And you've learnt the fricative sh and combined it with the to make your snare drum. So we've got our three sounds. So I'm going to do them and I want you to do them back to me. Ready? Now, we're going to put those into an 8-beat. Now, an 8-beat is simply 8 sounds in a row. 8 sounds in a row that repeat over and over and again. Now, in music, we might say that that's called a bar or a measure. We're going to just call it an 8-beat because it's easy to remember. There are 8 sounds in a row and they repeat. So you ready? We're going to do the first 4 sounds of our 8-beat together, like this. Now, it's very important that you make those sounds distinct, that they sound different from each other. Quite often when I'm teaching beatboxing, you hear people go, you know, and it doesn't sound great. Got to make those sounds really tight, really short, and really distinct. So it becomes. Brilliant. Now, the second 4 sounds are like this. Got it? So we're going to put the first 4 sounds and the second 4 sounds together to make our whole 8-beat. You can see the notation on the screen to follow as I do it. Do it with me. Now, do you notice that in the beat, the hi-hat is being put in between the other sounds? And in beatboxing, we do a lot of that. We do a beat, but we put the hi-hat in between. And we'll explain a bit why we do that in a later lesson. So that's all beatboxing is. It's doing that beat, but doing it a lot faster. And as you practice and practice and practice, you can build up speed. One mistake beatboxers make is to try and go too fast too quickly. We don't want to try and do that. Start slow, get it right. Timing is everything. It's got to be in time. If it's not in time, it's not going to sound good. Much better to do a simple beat and perfectly in time and really well than do a fast beat badly. And you hear a lot of beatboxers going too fast and tripping over the beats and they just haven't got it yet. I would much rather hear a beatboxer just go push. Than somebody doing it faster and making lots of mistakes. Now, in beatboxing, we just do those sounds and speed it up. So, that's the end of lesson 1. You've learnt that there are 4 kinds of sounds. You've learnt the difference between forced plosives and unforced plosives. And you've learnt the 3 basic sounds and how to put them together in a simple beat. Well, once you've mastered that, it's time to move on to lesson 2.